Introducing Professor Xiao Nonzhou, with an MSc in medical parasitology, a PhD in biology, and over 30 years' experience in infectious disease research, Zhou is the director of the National Institute of Parasitic Diseases at China CDC. Zhou is immensely passionate about conquering the neglected tropical diseases predominantly found in poor and rural areas of developing countries. But his fight is nothing new. Humans have forever been at war with plagues and viruses, and publishers like Springer and Nature have been sharing research on these diseases for over 175 years. The most ancient evidence of schistosomiasis dates back to more than 6,000 years ago, with the discovery of a terminal spine schistosome found in the pelvic sediment of a child's skeletal remains in Syria. Schistosome eggs have also been found in Egyptian mummies and in a 2,000-year-old corpse from China's Xi Han dynasty. Written accounts of conspicuous lesions, possibly cutaneous leishmaniasis, spread by bites from sandflies, also appear on tablets from the 7th century BCE. History's first recorded pandemic, the plague of Justinian, contributed to the fall of the Roman capital, Constantinople. It is estimated that more than 5,000 people per day died at its peak. In 1347, when merchant ships arrived in Italy full of sick sailors, the Black Death swept through the continent in just a few years, killing half of the European population. More than 25 million lives were lost over the next two centuries as pockets of plague reactivated. The first quarantines were introduced at that time. It was thought that the infectious disease was transmitted by bad air. Although the science was wrong, quarantine did help to prevent the spread of pneumonic plagues like smallpox. Throughout its history, smallpox has had a devastating effect on our world. In the 20th century alone, it is estimated to have killed up to 500 million people. It wasn't until the late 18th century that British doctor Edward Jenner discovered that milkmaids infected with cowpox seemed immune to smallpox. Jenner famously inoculated his gardener's 8-year-old son with cowpox before exposing him to smallpox. A few weeks later, it had had no effect. The gardener's son had developed antibodies, and so smallpox became the very first virus epidemic to be halted by a vaccine. In 2012, the World Health Organization developed a roadmap to eliminate neglected tropical diseases, encouraging global collaboration in a bid to speed up the process of finding solutions. However, Zhou became frustrated that the essential pockets of knowledge were so isolated, slowing the thought process in his research. So, later that year, helped by BMC, part of Springer Nature, Zhou launched an open access journal called Infectious Diseases of Poverty. The aim being to identify the research gaps that stand in the way of eradicating the infectious diseases connected with poverty. Nearly 10 years on, the journal has shared over 940 manuscripts, covering 36 thematic series on infectious diseases of poverty, and has contributions from nearly 5,000 authors. Zhou and his network of contributors have had a significant impact on the decline of infectious diseases of poverty, and a Chinese national program has now eliminated malaria. The same urgency and collaborative efforts that a younger Zhou dreamt about are also taming COVID-19. To combat the infectious diseases of poverty that are yet to be controlled across the poorest regions of our world, we must continue encouraging clinicians and public health workers to share their work and collaborate with peers. And global policymakers must take the lead from Zhou and his journal.